Hello everyone, in this video tutorial, we are going to look into the data fitting application of the neural network toolbox. This can be opened in three ways. Type NN start and click on fitting app. Now you have neural network fitting app open up. Or go to the apps tab and click on neural net fitting. Same windows open up. Or directly type in NF tool. The same windows open up. So you can read the introduction here, but it basically says that in the fitting problem, so you can use this network to fit the input and output data. So basically what we are doing is like function approximation. Click on next. Now you need to import the inputs and targets. So I will be using an example data set. Click on engine data set. In this we have two inputs, fuel rate and speed, and the two target value of torque and NOx emissions. We have 1199 samples of each. Click on import. Now I have selected matrix column. So what it means that for one first row we have the first input, and for the second row we have the second input, and each column represents one sample. Similarly for the engine target value. Click on next. You can divide the 1199 data samples we have in the training, validation and testing data sets. So let us keep it as default. Click on next. Now we have one hidden layer for this graphy user interface, but we can change the number of neurons in it. I will keep it at default value. Click on next. The network is created. Now you need to select the training algorithm. This Leuwenberg Marquardt algorithm is a faster algorithm, but it requires more memory. So basically we would like to use this algorithm as it saves time. But in real life problem, the data set we obtain are generally noisy. So in that case, we prefer to use Bayesian regularization algorithm. Select this and click on train. Now the network created will be trained, as that can be seen from this window. Let's discuss the various parameters given in here. We have used the data division of tandem. In case of time series data, we will be using the divide block. So what it does is that it selects a particular block from the data set we have available. We have selected the BR training algorithm. Performance function is mean square error. The epoch show the number of epoch, time the total time taken. Performance is the mean square error. Gradient is the gradient of the square of error function with respect to the unknown weights and biases. Weights and biases are the parameters we need to vary. Momentum update is a parameter used. It basically approximates the inverse of the Hessian matrix. So what it basically does that it prevents the minimum or minima of the function to be skipped by too high a gradient. So when this momentum update is just stopping criteria, so it represents that the network is trained good. Effective number of parameters. We know that all the parameters, weight and biases are not used. So this shows the effective number of parameters, and the sum square of these parameters shown here. Validation check criteria is not used in train BR training algorithm, but in case of train LM or train SCG, we will be using it as a stopping criteria. Performance plots the graph between the performance or the mean square error and the number of epochs. Training state plots various graphs like gradient versus number of epochs, momentum update, number of effective parameters, sum of square and the validation failure. Error histogram, as the name suggests, gives a histogram graph of the error. As you can see here, only training and test data is here, but no validation data set is available. This is because we have used train VR training algorithm. Regression gives the regression plot for this network. So as you can see, regression value is 0.9969, so it's very good. and fit gives the plot between the input and the target value. Close it. Click on next. You can train again the network if you are not satisfied with the result by adjusting the size of the network or importing a larger dataset. Click on next. Now you can generate a MATLAB function or create a Simulink diagram for this neural network, or just simply view the network. This like two inputs are there, one hidden layer with 10 neurons and two outputs. So Simulink diagram and the MATLAB function and the script for this will be discussed in the future videos. Click on next. Click on simple script. As you can see, this is a MATLAB generated script. This will be discussed in the future video. Now you have obtained the results like output, the error, and the network as well, and the various information related to it in the structure form. You can save this result in the MATLAB workspace by clicking on Save Result. So click on finish, and this is how you use the graphic user interface for the data fitting network in neural network toolbox. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and please like, subscribe and share.